So seeing the station type suggest and line type suggest, now distribution type arrestor if you take, these are intended for the pole mounting in distribution circuits for production of distribution transformer. Rating is 2500 amperes and 1500 amperes. Voltage ratings vary from 8 kV to 15 kV. So mainly the current discharge current rating, voltage rating, based on that they will be divided. So they can discharge current up to 65,000. Here see, it is 1 lakh amperes. Here 65,000 to 1 lakh amperes. This is up to 65,000 amperes. This is the discharge current. They are used mainly for pole mounted substations for the production of distribution transformers, including 15 kV classification. So these are the different types of arrestors. So if you take the location of the lightning arrestors, where the lightning arrestor should be located. Normal practice, these lightning arrestors should be placed as close as possible to the equipment. Normal lightning arrestors will be placed to the transformers, generators. Near to the equipment you have to place. Why? Why you have to place very near? This reduces chances of surges entering the circuit between protective equipment and equipment to be protected. Now that means between the equipment there should not be any chance of surge entry. Okay. And another thing is, if there is a distance between the two, that means protective device and equipment to be protected, then steep fronted wave after being incident on the arrestor, once the arrestor is sparks over, corresponding to spark power voltage SOV, it enters the transformer after traveling over the lead between the two. That means after this it enters into the transformer because there is a gap between those two. Then that wave suffers reflection at the terminal end. Therefore, total voltage at the terminal of the transformer is sum of reflected and incident voltage. You know these traveling waves. Reflected voltage, incident voltage. And what happens? Finally, it becomes twice the incident voltage. That means if the gap between lightning arrestor and transformer, this voltage suffers reflection. Therefore, it becomes two times that. So transformer may experience a surge twice as that of the lightning arrestor. So therefore, if the lightning arrestor is right at the terminals, this could not occur. And another point is, let us take it, the L is the inductance of the lead between the two. That means a protective device and lightning arrestor. Protective device means lightning arrestor and equipment will be protected. If L is the inductance between those two, if IR, the residual voltage of the lightning arrestor, then the voltage incident in the transformer is V is equal to IR plus LDI by DT, where DI by DT is the rate of change of surge current. It is possible to provide some separation between the two, where the capacitor is connected to the terminals of the equipment. So this reduces the steepness of the wave, and hence the rate of DI by DT. This also reduces the steepness of the distribution or the winding of the equipment. So that means, if there is a gap between those two, it leads to increase in the current and the traveling waves will be there. So that's why you have to locate the lightning arrestor as near to the equipment as possible. So what is the rating of the lightning arrestor? I said the lightning arrestor rating is expressed in terms of phase voltage, that means line to ground voltage. Lightning arrestor expressed to discharge the currents of very large magnitude. Why we are expressing the rating in the voltage? Why not in current? Let us see. Normally, they are expected to discharge large currents of very large magnitude, thousands of amperes. But the time is very short. In microseconds, they will discharge the entire current. So the energy that is dissipated through the lightning arrestor is very small, because no time, current is there, but time is less. Therefore, what we can say, energy dissipated is very small compared to what is would happen if the few amperes of power frequency current have been thrown for few cycles. If you take very small current, if it is flowing for few seconds, it will have more energy. It is a large current, but it is flowing for microseconds, it has less energy. So that's why compared to normal frequency current, this current, the energy associated with this lightning current is very small. So that's why this current will not be, okay. So that's why current will not be taken for the rating purpose. Therefore, the main consideration in selecting the rating of the lightning arrestor is line to ground dynamic voltage to which arrestor may be subjected for any condition of the system. An allowance of 5% is normally assumed to take the rating, to take into account the lightning operating condition under no load, because the no load condition, we know that there is 5% rise in the voltage, that 5% will be taken, okay, due to Faraday effect. This means 105%, an arrestor of 105% is used on the system where line to ground voltage may reach line to line value during line to ground fault condition. So this is the way the rating of the lightning arrestor will be taken in terms of voltage, not in terms of current. So now we are going to the topic, insulation coordination with the what I said, VD curves. Now coordination, what do you mean by coordination? What is insulation coordination? Insulation coordination is a correlation of the insulation of the electrical equipment and lines with the characteristics of the protective device. Here the insulation of the devices, which are whose insulation to be protected, their characteristics should be correlated with the characteristics of the devices which are protecting this equipment. That coordination is required, such that what happens, the insulation of the whole power system is protected from the excessive power voltage. Okay, what insulation you have to provide for the equipment? What is the device you have selected? If there is a matching, a correlation, there is a relation between these two, then entire equipment protection, equipment will, power system will be protected. So the main aim of insulation coordination is selection of suitable values of the insulation level of the different components. So every component, transformer as well as circuit breaker and the lines, these will be given different insulation levels. So that selection of insulation level is important. How to select the insulation of different equipment? It depends upon the insulation coordination. So the whole power system will be protected from excessive power voltages. So insulation coordination is thus matching of volt time flashover and breakdown characteristics of the equipment and protective devices. So should take the volt time characteristics of the protective device as well as protecting device. That matching you have to consider. So let us see the volt time characteristics. This plays very important role in the insulation coordination. So it is kV peak versus time, if you take, where A is the volt time characteristics of the protective device. Protective device means lightning arrestor, etc. Where B is the volt time characteristics of the equipment to be protected. So what we can say from this figure, that any insulation having the voltage withstanding strength in excess of the insulation strength of the curve B will be protected by the device of curve A. Will be divided. Okay, what we can say, any equipment having the insulation strength, voltage withstanding strength more than this B, it is protected by the protecting device with characteristics. That means line, transformer, anything, it should be more than this level. That will be protected by one protective device. So that is called insulation coordination. So to understand this, one should understand the volt time curve. This is very important. I repeatedly talking about this. This is voltage versus time in microseconds. So the breakdown voltage of any insulation or flashover of the gap. So if you take insulation, we'll take the breakdown voltage where it flashes over. If you take any rod gap or anything, flashover, we'll talk about that. It depends upon the magnitude of the voltage and time of application. Always we are saying, we'll express the over voltage in terms of some wave, impulse wave, etc. It has some shape, magnitude, time of application. These are important. So depends upon the magnitude of the voltage as well as time of application, how much time you are applying to withstand that. Based on that, we will decide the breakdown voltage of insulation. So that's why volt time curve is a graph of crest flashover voltages plotted against time to flashover. for series of impulse applications of the same wave shape. So we will give different voltages of different magnitudes, but same wave shape. If you take one wave shape, impulse wave shape, the same wave shape will be given, but different magnitudes. We'll test the insulation when it is flashing over, when it is withstanding, all these things. We'll take all the different terminology now. The construction of the voltage curve is based on the application of the impulse voltages of the same wave shape but different peak values of insulation, whose voltage curve is required. So let us see the various terms associated. As I said, we'll apply the voltage of same shape but different voltage levels, and we'll observe when the insulation flash over, when it is not flash over. So that is important. These voltage curves should match, or that means should correlate with the voltage curves of the protective device. Then one device can protect the entire equipment. So that is called insulation coordination. So let us take the front flashover. What is the meaning of this? If an impulse voltage of given wave shape and polarity is adjusted, we'll apply the voltage adjusted such that the test specimen means insulation of particular component flashes over on the front of the wave. If it flashes over on the front of the wave, the value of the voltage corresponding to this point on the front of the wave is called front flashover. Okay, that value will be taken. So what is the crest flashover? If the impulse voltage of the again same wave shape is adjusted, again the voltage value is adjusted, so that the test specimen, first you see the critical flashover, the test specimen flashover for 50% applications, and it does not flashover for other 50% of the applications at the tail of the wave. At the tail of the wave, it is called critical flashover. Critical means for 50% it doesn't flashover, 50% it will flashover. Based on this, the voltage ratings will be decided. What is crest flashover? Crest means top of the hill, like that we can say. If an impulse voltage of the same wave shape is applied, if that causes the test specimen to flash over exactly on the crest value, it is called crest flashover. What is a full wave or a chopped wave? Full wave means if the flashover does not take place during the wave application, it is a full wave. That means I said same wave with the different magnitudes are applied. What is a chopped wave? If the flashover occurs, it is called chopped wave. What is a critical withstand voltage? Critical withstand voltage means if an impulse voltage is reduced to just below the flashover voltage of the test specimen, and is called critical withstand voltage. That means it will withstand such type of voltages just below the flashover voltage. What is the rated withstand voltage? The crest value of the impulse wave that the test specimen will withstand without any disruptive discharge. Without any discharge, if it is withstand, that is called rated withstand voltage. So this is the way different voltages we can observe from this voltage curves. Okay, these are waves, same shape, but different magnets you are applying. We are observing when it flash over, when it does not flash over. This is the time range wave for tail flashover. At this point, it is flashing over. This is the time range. This is the time range for front flashover, time versus voltage. You see, it is the time range for no flashover. That means if the application time is this much, it will flashover in the front wave itself. In this range, it may flashover at the tail side. In this range, it may not flashover. That means time of application is important, as well as magnitude of the voltage is important to test the insulation level, withstanding level. So the important thing is BIL, basic impulse insulation level. What is this BIL, common level? You understand this properly. I said these are lightning arrester voltage curve. These are the voltage curves of the bus bar, line, and as well as transformer. So BIL means common level should be given, a common insulation level for all the insulation of the station is known as basic insulation level, BIL, which have been established in terms of withstanding voltage of the apple supply. why this BAL discussion has come. Let us see. Insulation strength of the equipment like transformer, circuit breakers, etc. should be higher than that of the lighting or another such protective device. This is what I said. In order to protect the equipment of the power system from over voltages of excessive magnitude, it is necessary to fix the insulation level for the system to see that any insulation in the system does not break down or flash over below this level. We have to set some basic insulation level. We have to set some basic insulation level such that any insulation should not flash over. If this insulation level is maintained, that means the insulation level should not be below this. Anything insulation above this level, then there is no problem. So that is called basic insulation level. Several methods for providing coordination between insulation levels in the station and the line leading to the station have been offered. There are several methods. What is the best method out of all these things is to establish a definite common level for all insulation in the station. Bring all the insulation to or above this level. So there are several methods. BAL is the best method. So to establish one common level, so that every equipment insulation must be above this, such that entire equipment will be protected. So this limits, and because of this BAL, this limits the problem of to three fundamental requirements. What are those? Selection of suitable insulation level. Assure is that the breakdown or flashover strength of all insulation in the station will be equal or exceed the selected level. There will be proper assurance. And application of protective devices that will give apparatus a good protection can be justified economically. So because of this BAL maintenance, these three can be properly maintained. So that is called BAL. Let us see. So what is the basic impulse insulation level? There are different standards here if you observe. As a reference level expressed in terms of impulse crest voltage. Just now I said what is crest voltage? The peak curve. So BAL is expressed in terms of crest voltage standard value not longer than 1.2 to 50 microseconds. I said, what is the lightning impulse? It takes 1.2 microseconds to reach the peak value and 50 microseconds to fall 50% of the peak value. So this is according to Indian standards. According to ESA standards, 1.5 by 40 microseconds. According to UK standards, it is 1 by 50 microseconds. So this is the standard impulse crest value. Based on this, the base BAL can be defined. Apparatus insulation, as demonstrated by suitable test, should be equal to or greater than BAL. I said insulation level should be either equal to BAL or more than the BAL, not less than the BAL, common level. The basic impulse insulation level for the system is selected such that the system could be protected with a suitable lighting protective device. Suitable lighting arrester can be selected. Margin between BAL and lighting arrester should be fixed. BAL means basic insulation, lighting arrester level. This margin, this is lighting arrester below, BAL is above. Any insulation should be more than this BAL, I said. So this margin should be fixed such that it is economical and it also ensures protection to the system. BAL chosen must be higher than the maximum expected circuit voltage across the selected arrester. So this is about the insulation coordination, voltage curves and BAL.